Not a Christian Life Assembly. Praise the Lord. If you just tuned in tonight, we are praying for you. We pray for several. If you have a need, let us know. Those who watch us regularly, we're so glad you're with us again tonight. And we're going to sing in just a moment here. We did want to make note of just a couple, three things for us coming up. We did have an awesome time Sunday. We had a couple things up there for us. God blessed us. Check out the video. I think you'll be blessed with it. And this Sunday, June 5th, Brother Roy Walls will be with us for the Sunday morning services. So if you get a chance to watch us or join us, we'd love to have you with us. And we're working on some other events coming up soon. I have a missionary coming the last Sunday of the month. She'll be sharing with us. She's going to, if memory serves, Senegal in Africa. And so I'm happy to have her come. We want to have that vision and focus of God's mission all over the world. So, and some other announcements we'll have as we get it together. So right now we're going to worship the Lord. I appreciate Brother Woody and Brother Bob. And God bless you guys. Amen. Let's give him praise tonight.
Good, isn't he? Did you come to worship the Lord?
Hallelujah.
Did you come to lift him up and praise him? Because he's worthy.
Yes.
Glory to God.
Just a moment, please.
Nearer, 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 blessed Lord.
He is our Lord. Amen.
Is he your Lord? Let's just worship him.
Oh, he is Lord. He is Lord. He has risen from the dead, and he is Lord. Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord.
You know, it's good to know the Lord. Mm-hmm. And sometimes we need to just reflect on our relationship with God and with others. And kind of look back. You know, most married couples, once a year they have an anniversary. And that's a very special time, and for them to reflect on when they got married. Pam and I planned on doing it this year, but we didn't quite make it to the anniversary. She had all her plans made and everything. But you know, it's a wonderful thing.
Amen. Mm-hmm.
And sometimes, you know, as married couples and friends and church family and whatever, we love one another. We take each other for granted, and you know, and we have a good close relationship. But there's times that we need to reflect on our beginnings.
Amen.
In Revelation, Jesus Christ said, "You left your first love." Mm-hmm. And there's times that we need to renew our love. Mm-hmm. There's times that we just. In ministry, there's just times that we need some times of encouragement and lifting up. And I know that these verses are read a lot in this church, and it has to do with communion. And I'm going to present a few things that has to do with communion. I don't know if you've heard it before or not, but it's just to encourage one another. And reflect one another. 1 Corinthians 11 and 24 says, "And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'Take, eat, this is my body, which was broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me.' In the same manner, he also took the cup after supper, saying, 'This is the cup of my New Testament. This is the cup of my new covenant in my blood. This do as often as you do drink it in remembrance of me.'" And you know, we serve God every day. God is a part of our life every day.
Amen.
And I will say this, that God is a major part of my life every day. He is the main part of my life every day. But he's saying here, when you take communion, to do it in remembrance of him. And like it's a special time and a special remembrance. And what does communion represent? It represents the death and burial and resurrection of Jesus Christ. Sometimes, you know, as married couples, and as church members, and as children of God, we need to reflect on our beginnings. Our new beginnings. And there's times that we need to take it serious. Now, communion celebrates what Jesus Christ did on the cross. It celebrates his gift that he gave to you and I. Such a wonderful and great gift. And you know, we've been living for the Lord years and years, and many, many years have gone by in a lot of cases. And in my case, it's more than most of you have been alive. But you know, and I always remember that Jesus Christ is not only my Lord, he's my Savior, he's my friend, he's my comforter, he's my companion. And you know, since I now live alone, he's a greater companion through the day, than he fills the gap for me.
Thank you.
And truly wonderful. Do it in remembrance of me. So what's Jesus Christ is really saying? In remembrance of me. Verse 26 says, for as often as you eat and drink, you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death till he comes. You know, I know people that I've met people down through the years that they are, maybe they're insecure in their salvation or whatever, but they take communion every day in their home. They're trying to secure their salvation to it. And there are organizations out there that says that salvation comes through communion.
That's true.
And communion is just a celebration of what Jesus did. And what did he really do? He died for our sins. He gave up all. And Calvary is the most glorious part in the Bible. Calvary is the thing that is most magnificent in the Bible. It's a glorious, you know. And this spirit of Calvary should be in us every day. But you know, there needs to be these special times that we remember what Calvary is all about. And then we take time, and communion is the time that Christ said that we should do it. We should reflect on that. And I pointed out what communion is all about on God's side, but what is it all about on our side, your side and my side? Communion represents as to us as individuals when we came to Jesus Christ. When we came to Jesus Christ. And we should remember it in a special way because it's a holy time. You know, when you're born again, you're not just partially forgiven of your sins, but every sin that you ever committed is forgiven when you're born again. Calvary does a complete job. Yes, the old flesh comes back and struggles with things sometimes. You know? And we need to take time to reflect on what communion really is. It's a holy time. It's a holy celebration with Jesus Christ. And you know, communion made a way. Calvary made a way for the world to come to Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ shed his blood on Calvary. And you know, the way some people think that it is from there on into the future, which we live in, the days that we live in, brought salvation. But without Calvary, the Old Testament would not have salvation. Amen. You know, the Bible talks about the letter of the law. Mm-hmm. And the letter of the law, Old Testament law. And it talks about the righteousness of the law. Mm-hmm. And the righteousness of the law, it still carries over today. But I'm going to reflect a little bit on what it was in the Old Testament and why Calvary was necessary for the law in the Old Testament. The doing of the law could not save you. Repeating and keeping the law in the flesh and faithfully could not save you. But you know, in the New Testament, it tells us that the righteousness of the law is those that kept it by faith. They kept it by faith. Mm-hmm. And in the Old Testament, when they kept it by faith, when Jesus Christ died on the cross and shed his blood went back and covered all that was under the Old Testament so that they could enter in. They could not enter in until Jesus Christ died on the cross. And he went down into the lower parts of the earth and set the captives free.
Thank you, Lord.
He set them free. So communion went back and touched the lives of the believers in the Old Testament, the ones that kept the law by faith. And it's the same today. We can live by rules and regulations, and that does not make the law that we're keeping righteous. What keeps the law righteous in our lives is when we do it by faith. When we do it by faith. And it's completely necessary. You know, it is just so tremendous and it's so good that the law was kept by faith.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And sometimes we need to reflect on that. And communion is a time that Christ said, point it out. Remember that time. And come back to the place that you were. Remember when you first got born again. And you come to that place in your spirit each time you take communion. That was God's plan, and that's the way that he teaches it. Come back to that place. You know, take care of the little things in your life that shouldn't be. Take care of it when you come to communion and start anew and start afresh, you know. Mm-hmm. Because the Lord is truly wonderful. And the Bible teaches that the just shall live by faith. You know, we need to, it tells us to walk in love. Walk in love. Mm-hmm. Spiritually, we should live in that condition every day. Mm-hmm. The Bible tells us without holiness, no man shall see God. Mm-hmm. And what makes us holy and pure? It's not, you can't do it by the keeping of the law. You can't legislate it. You can't make a set of rules. But holiness is a condition of your heart that is created through Calvary. Mm-hmm. Created through Calvary. And you know, it feels so good when the Lord, you can feel the Lord has washed all your sins away.
Amen.
It's such a magnificent thing, isn't it? Mm-hmm. When he's washed our sins away. And we know that we're born again. Mm-hmm. We know that we're a child of God. It's a magnificent thing because you can feel his cleansing power inside of you. That fellowship that you have in time of communion, we live through that. We should have that each and every day. You know, don't take Jesus for granted.
That's right.
Don't say, I've been walking this road for 50 years and I know how to do it.
That's right.
One time, I was sitting in a church, and there was a pastor that he was a bishop. Everybody looked up to him, and he just you know, he knew how to do things, and when he got up, his spirit would begin to move. And he was sitting there with his Bible open, and he stood up and he said, "I have something to say." He said, "I've been doing this thing so many times, I just do it naturally, just like breathing." And he said, "I've been doing it wrong. I've been doing it wrong. Because I haven't been doing it spiritually. I haven't took time for the remembrance and renewing of God in our lives." You know? Everyone who gets up and speaks before God or witnesses, if you witness to somebody in Walmart or whatever, you need to realize and have a little fear of God in there, that so that it reaches out and touches others. Mm-hmm. Touches others. Because the Spirit of God that lives in us is what makes us alive. When you're born again, the Bible teaches us that old things pass away and all things become new. And we're new creatures in Christ Jesus. New creatures, you know. Mm-hmm. Maybe some of us in here, if we weren't children of God and washed in the blood of the Lamb, maybe we wouldn't want to get in fellowship with each other. You know, Woody might say, "I'm getting away from that guy, he's crazy." And you know, my list of people that I fellowship is different because of the Spirit of God that lives in me and lives in them. Truly, the Lord is wonderful. And the righteousness of the law is so important. It's so important that we keep that righteousness and that holiness. That we serve God. He says we are walk in the newness of life. In the newness of life. Well, what is that? Does that mean just to follow this roadmap? It does mean follow the roadmap, but it means so much more. So much more. You know? My heart is set on God.
Amen.
My mind is set on God. The very thoughts and intents of my heart is set on God. Because there's something that's just so powerful about God that draws me. It's not that I'm different. We're different than the world. But in Christ Jesus, we all have the same drawing power. Mm-hmm. We all have the same relationship. We all have the same condition. But it's up to us. God, Jesus said here, take time for remembrance. Take time for remembrance. Mm-hmm. Remember your beginning. Remember when I sacrificed on Calvary. Remember when you first took your trip to Calvary. I said it a couple months ago that I know in Cedar Gap, Kentucky, I can take you to the place where I found my Calvary. Thank you, Lord. And you and I have a place where we found Calvary and we entered into it. And, you know, just like when we take communion, you enter into that holy communion with God. You know, that's where our Calvary is. That's where our relationship is. That's where our eternal life lays in Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. Our eternal life. Amen. And, you know, I want the glory side of Jesus Christ.
That's right.
I want the victory side of Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. And yes, we may struggle at times in the flesh and we may go through a lot of things in the flesh. If you're a child of God, you're going to fight some battles. There's no way around it. Mm-hmm. You're going to fight some battles.
True.
And if you're not a child of God, you already lost yourself in those battles. You're steeped failure. But you know, remembrance. This type of remembrance that Christ was talking about through communion, it's what set you free. It's what you set free. And you know, we can live for God, and Satan comes along dragging the chains that you threw off that day. He's dragging them behind and trying to give them back to you. Mm-hmm. Satan does everything he can to put you in bondage. But I serve a God that's not only a Savior, He's not only a Lord, He's not only a miracle worker, He's not only all things, but He's also a chain breaker.
Amen.
Chain breaker that breaks every chain, that takes every bondage away, that makes us free. The Word says, He who the Son sets free is free indeed.
Right.
You know? Yeah. You know, maybe I can't hide y'all. Like I did when I was a young teenager. I can no longer do that. But I had the freedom in my spirit.
Thank you.
I had the freedom in my spirit. You know, and that's what I want, to be free in Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. He is with us every day.
Hallelujah.
He is with us every day. His Spirit is with us. And you know, He's there through the thick and the thin. He's there in the good times, and He's there in the bad times. When life gets stormy, that's where the Lord is. Mm-hmm. He is not only God of the good times, but He's also God, the God of the storms. He's the God of every battle that we ever fight. And you know, I'll be the first one to admit, I have had a lot of victory in my life. And a lot of people have seen victory in my life. But I'll be the first one to admit, I fought some mighty hard battles at times. You face battles at times. And you hang in there, and you know that victory lies in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Victory lies in Him. And I know that it's not God coming short, but it's my understanding and my faith. I'm still studying. I'm still digging. And I could probably teach this Bible from cover to cover. A lot of it I have. Bible studies have been a major part of my ministry. But there's still a lot in there. And you can read things, and you can read over it, and maybe let's say I've been through the New Testament 150 times, maybe 200 times. I don't know. You know, but here it came out, do this in remembrance of me. Mm-hmm. It's something that, it's like it jumped out at me. Mm-hmm. And I never quite looked at it that way before. Mm-hmm. You know? And you kind of think, Lord, you're my Lord, my Savior. I always remember You. Mm-hmm. But He's talking about remembering in a special way. In a special way. Recall it. Mm-hmm. Like a married couple that want to renew their vows in a special way. We need those special times with Jesus Christ. We need those intimate times in our with Jesus Christ so that we can renew our strength. Renew our strength. You know, as human, we can get battle weary sometimes. You know, sometimes the battle continues on and they rage for a long time. And you know, and I've known people, it didn't matter how heavy the battle was, my mother was one of them. She held on to the end. And you know, she is one that I could look at and look up to her, I could say she was my mentor. She taught me. But I've seen others when the battle raged and it continued on, that they stumbled. Some stumbled. Some stumbled and fall. So, you know, we need this time of remembrance when it gets hard, you know. And I can't get over it. About once a month, Nathan reads this portion of this chapter. I can't get over how special it always sounds to me. How special it is. Because it represents the day that Jesus Christ, his love was fulfilled in our lives. And he gave himself completely over. And you know, I've had a lot of people that bring their hard questions to me. And this minister, one time, we were in a group, and he was teaching. And he kind of stopped, and he said, "I have a question for Bob. Why did Jesus come at the time that he did? You know, why didn't he come earlier? Why didn't he come later?" And I thought it over, you know. Jesus Christ came to reconcile us back to sin, back to him, to do away with our sin. And he didn't leave the Old Testament out, because they were living the law by faith. He had a holding place. You can read about it in the New Testament, called Abraham's bosom. He had a holding place for those who kept the law by faith, who kept the law through righteousness. And you know, maybe he came to a place where the multitudes were getting so great, and he said, "It's time. This is where I need to put my time on him." But can you imagine? He created heaven and earth, knowing that he was going to suffer and die on Calvary. It's clear that Jesus Christ and the Heavenly Father laid it out. Maybe the Father said to Jesus, "If you create earth and you create man in this way, in our image, and you give him free will, there's going to come a time that they're going to fall and they need redeemed." And it was a serious time for Jesus. And maybe he debated, "Should I create man? Should I create man? Because I'm going to have to lay my life down for them one day." But he went ahead and he did, because he loved you and I. His sacrifice, Calvary, was planned from the foundations of this earth. The Bible teaches that Calvary was planned from the foundation of this earth. Did God create earth with a plan to fall? No, he gave man free choice. And he knew what they would do. He knew that they would stumble and fall. So there's times that we need to remember who he is. There's times that we need to reflect on that closeness of God. And to draw our spirit back to the beginning, that we are renewed again, that we're new creatures, that we're walking in the newness of life. And then we find the joy and the strength and hope and help from Jesus Christ. Because the Lord didn't forget anything. He didn't leave anything out.
Sure.
When he died on the cross, he said, "It is finished." He completed. Mm-hmm. And you know, he made a way for every one of us. Mm-hmm. He gave a gift to every one of us. And he did know that some would receive it and some would not. Mm-hmm. It's my desire, such a great gift, that the whole world would receive it. This world right now is in trouble in a lot of ways. high gas and everything else, inflation, if the whole world would come to Jesus Christ, it would change. It would change instantly. You know, it would be a tremendous place to live on earth. And earth is going to become that way someday when Jesus Christ comes back in the second coming to make things right. So, you know, when we do communion, let's reflect on the remembrance, the holy part, the new beginning for you and I, the new beginning for mankind, the hope in Jesus Christ that you and I have. Truly, truly, He's a wonderful God.
Yes.
Truly, He's a magnificent God.
He is, yes.
And you know, He's still standing on the edge of eternity with outstretched arms for the lost. He's still saying, "Come unto me, all ye that are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." He's still the chain breaker. He's still the one who takes away all the bondage. You know? And maybe I can't run a 4-minute mile anymore, but in my spirit, that doesn't slow down what's in my heart. That doesn't take the thrill out of my soul. The thrill of knowing Jesus Christ. The thrill of having eternal life. The thrill of having these blessings. And the thrill of being cleansed. Being cleansed. Washed in His blood. Made whole again. Renewed in Him. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we love You and we praise You. And we just thank You. We thank You for the gift of eternal life, God. We thank You that Your hand is upon us. And God, we thank You that You see us through. And yes, Lord, the trials and tests sometimes gets a little hard and a little overwhelming. But You're there all the time. You're our assurance that we have victory. You're our assurance that we have made it through. As long as we don't back down and walk away from You, we have won the crown of life. We have won eternal life. We have won the victory. We have found the strength and the joy. We have a power, a source of power from above. A source of power from above. There is a river that flows from the throne of God. There is a river. And you know, the word says, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. I want to live in that stream of life. I want to live in that life. And you know, yes, I'm looking for victory in every battle and healing on every side. One thing that matters is that I have victory in my soul and in my life. Because Jesus Christ died on the cross. Because He gave His all for you and I. And if there's anyone under the sound of my voice who needs a special miracle, God, I pray that You give it to them. I pray that You just help them. That You just be with them, Lord. We love You and we worship You and we pray that You meet every need. Heal everyone that needs healed.
Yes.
Bring finances to everyone that needs to find it.
Yes.
Lord, we love You and thank You. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. We remember Jesus tonight, what He did for us on the cross. I appreciate our brother tonight as he shared. He's not feeling the greatest tonight, but Brother Bob has been touched by the Lord and strengthened to share. And I just appreciate the Lord tonight. I appreciate Brother Bob and the word that He's given him. And so we love you out there tonight. As he prayed, God wants to do good things, but we have to trust Him, have that faith. So we pray that for you. Pray God's blessings for you. We'll see you real soon, Christian.